Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel, Tarot Dreamer. These are our monthly readings for July 2023 and this is for, it's for Aries. Okay Aries, so Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. These can also be timeless readings. It's really whenever you come across this video, is there's a message for you there from the Divine, the Spirit. Okay guys. And thanks to all my new subscribers as well. And for those that haven't subscribed, please do so. Because once we reach 777 subscribers, I'll be launching my Tarot After Dark, which is tarot for all the different star signs. And it's purely relationship based. Okay, let's get into your reading, Aries. This is for July 2023. Light Seer's tarot deck, and we'll be clarifying if needed with our fortune cards. And our first card we've got out for Aries, it's the Strength card. Okay, there we go, it's a Strength card there. The Page of Swords. Nice, the Magician. Lovely, the Four of Wands. Okay, the Five of Wands. And our final card is the Knight of Swords. And the energy on the bottom of the deck is the Knight of Wands. Okay, give me a moment, Aries, to make sure all the cards are in focus for you and to connect with your reading. Okay guys, this is a relationship reading here. We start off in the recent past. This is a long-term commitment. This could be a marriage. There could be somebody in a marriage where you're finding out that somebody is wearing a mask. Somebody isn't who they appear to be here. Now, with the Strength card, this person is connected to you through some kind of relationship commitment here. With the Four of Wands being the 11-11 card, the card of... it's usually a card linked to marriage as well. But there's a connection here that has required a lot of strength. So it's also taken it out of you, this connection here with this person, Aries. You've had to put on a strong face here, a strong, almost a mask. You've had to put your feelings aside and be strong for everybody else that is involved in this connection. So it might not just be you, it could be a family situation, a family scenario here that is affecting others. But this is about to change with the other cards that we have in this reading. Because whoever this is, it's either someone who is now going to start doing things to please themselves. So in other words, they're going to start putting themselves first here. Whereas before, this could be you, Aries, you were putting others first in your connection. So your family, your spouse, your partner. And now, that was in the recent past, now you are moving forward. And you're starting to concentrate in July on yourself here. So with the Page of Swords, this is new ideas coming in, how you want to live your life. But this could also be spying on somebody. Something has come to your attention here. And they're asking me to say that whatever this is that will be coming to your attention or being brought to your attention, you notice the birds either side here. There's lots of overthinking with what this person is looking at here. It's going to cause conflict in your connection. There's five people here. Again, somebody is bringing conflict into a connection, a partnership. And I feel it's because of something you have or you will be finding out. Now, in the later stages of July, we have the Magician moving in here. But with the Magician and the Knight of Swords, this is somebody literally running after or running away from a situation where they could have felt manipulated. Now, if you look at the first card that we started with here, you can see the affinity symbol on the Strength card and on the Magician. This is a cycle that's been going on for a long time with this connection. And it's as if you've been going around and around different cycles, ups and downs with this person. This is finally coming to an end here with the Knight of Swords. Somebody is leaving this connection. Now, I have a feeling you could feel that this person has been manipulated or they have manipulated you. But someone wants to make a break. And underneath, we've got the Knight of Wands. This is a very passionate person here. A very passionate energy, I should say. Now, the Knight of Swords is to do with clarity and going after what you truly feel is yours. But I get from this Aries that this isn't you. This could be the person that you're connected with and they're being influenced here by the Knight of Wands. And as we move further down the deck, we have a decision coming in here with the Two of Swords. Now, this is a decision that this person isn't seeing clearly and others are interfering in this decision that is needed to be made in order to move away from this connection. This person needs to make a decision, but there's too much interference from others at this stage. Now, if this person, this could be you, this could be your partner, when they make this choice, it brings down the Wheel of Fortune, which is a closing of a cycle here. And it's going to lead to somebody feeling as if they did not even know this person. Somebody could even be getting chucked out of their family home here and literally being left out in the cold. Because there is a secret coming up or coming out. And it could be to do with somebody who has feelings for either you, Aries, or your partner. That's a younger person that is going to be expressing these feelings. And they're saying, keep going. So we've got the King of Swords here. Finally, somebody is going to get clarity in this situation. Let's start clarifying this reading and dive a little deeper into some of these cards. So let's clarify with the Strength card, please. Let's clarify it with the Strength card. Right, there's a child here. There's children involved. To me, this is a family situation here. And somebody has been putting on a brave face for the sake of the children in this connection. This isn't going to be for all of you, but there's a marriage here, there's a connection, there's children involved, and somebody has been staying in the marriage for the sake of the children here. Now this is all about to change. So let's clarify the Page of Swords also, please. Let's clarify the Page of Swords. Okay, and that's a gift. And they're asking me to explain this in detail here. There's a blessing in disguise coming with what you're about to find out here with this Page of Swords. There's something you're going to find out that's going to cause conflict. But it is a blessing in disguise here, because there has been a lot of manipulation going on with the Magician, which I feel is your person. Yeah. They're saying wool has been pulled over your eyes for too long here, Aries. I'm surprised the Tower isn't here, because there is something that's going to happen in the middle of the month of July that is going to then cause somebody to run away from this connection. So please clarify the Magician. Let's clarify the Magician, please. And again, I said that there was a message here that's going to cause conflict, and there's a message here that's on the Magician. Somebody is manipulating somebody else here in a connection for their own gain. Normally the Magician can be manifesting, it's positive, but with the card and the Knight of Swords underneath, someone is going to get very clear on what they want here in this connection. Okay, and let's clarify the Four of Wands. And there we go. You could not get any clearer than that. And I'm going to... Great Fortune is underneath the deck here. There's money involved in here. There's assets that need to be split. But we have the Privileged Lady on literally what I said was the marriage card here. This is the third party connection that is influencing your person in this connection. And it's linked with the Knight of Wands. And it's linked with the decision. And it's going to be linked with the closing of the cycle here. Somebody is going to be out in the cold after someone finds out a secret here. But what they're telling me is this is going to be a trying time for some in a connection here. But you have Great Fortune underneath the deck. So there are fortunate events that this is going to turn around in your favour, Aries. And it will be a blessing in disguise, because of course nobody wants to carry on with somebody who is cheating or doing things behind their back and not being honest about it here. So this, whatever's going to happen in July, the masks are going to start to fall off. Someone is going to start putting themselves first. And whatever you find out in the middle of July, it's going to be a blessing in disguise through all of this. Because in the end, someone is making a break to be with somebody who they really want to be with. And it's going to give the other person final closure and to be able to move on in a situation that they have felt stuck in the past. Okay, guys, I really hope you've enjoyed your reading for July 2023. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe. And always believe in yourself, follow your dreams and stay blessed.